Welcome back to the channel. We are continuing with American Truck Simulator. We're going to try to finish this load that we have. Hopefully we'll make it in a decent amount of time. Just at a rest stop. The dude's rested. So now we are going to get boogie. I think we go out this way. I'm guessing. We got a dual trailers here, so we got to be careful of the dang curb. I think we're going to curb it. But those trailers are used to it anyways. And we made it, just barely. I guess we're good to go. Assuming I'm going the right way. Yeah, I curved it again. It's hard not to. Trip here. Might be a long episode. I think we had a detour is what screwed us up the last time. And seems to be what screws us up most of the time is these detours. They add miles to us. But the load, if everything goes the way it's supposed to go, it's expected in like Saturday at 2:45. Delivery expectation is, I think, 7. I had it written down, but 5 would be between 5 and 6:30. So, providing we don't have any hiccups along the way, we should be way ahead of schedule delivering it. I just hope this guy can do the whole 500 miles, because if he can't, then we're screwed. He's fully rested, so there's no excuse for him not to. I've got to figure out how to shut that stupid, basically, brake thing off. That's why every time I let off the gas, the brake kicks in. It's helpful keeping speed, but it's just annoying as hell to have that retarder thing come on there all the time. I personally do not know how the hell I can activate it. It says I'm supposed to be in this lane, but I bet you anything, this lane is a exit only. Yeah, they put us in that lane for no reason. So supposedly faster traffic can get by me. What if traffic was so bad and I was stuck in this? They would have put me in a detour. Or not a detour, but put me in a spot where I'd be driving a lot of miles for no reason. So between the two episodes, I think we did 400 miles on that last episode, so that'll be like 900 miles total between the two, from free roaming from Arizona up to Vegas to get this load, from Vegas to Twin Oaks, I think it is, or something. What a yahoo. a lot to get back up to speed. When you have to slow down that much, and the speed is supposed to be 80 through here, which I think that's a bit much for pushing a truck, but what am I saying? I've gone 85 in this truck. Since we got stuck behind that semi back there, that slowed us down to 50. I believe it was under 50. It's taken us a long time just to get it up to 60, 65. So, not a happy camper with that BS. Because there's no reason that bus could stay in that other lane. He could have moved over long before that. So I had no way to get around anybody. Even thinking about rest areas or anything like that, just maybe a fuel stop along the way is all we need. Detours or something, and I'll say I hit somebody. I don't know who the hell I hit, but the trailer behind me that I'm pulling might have hit somebody, but that's what happens when they're not watching out for the trucks. And there's only so much view that you have, so. Okay, there's a structure, something coming up. It's shoulder construction. It really doesn't affect the road much. But whatever. Jesus. Truck up there ain't going no 80. sneak over into the right lane again. Obviously, that truck up there is a speed demon like myself, and there's no way I'm going to catch up to him right now. And there's no point hogging up the passing lane just because I want to not have people in front of me too close. Before I do the next episode, I am definitely... Jeez, this is dangerous. I'm definitely going to figure out what the brake thing is, how to shut it off, because it's really annoying to have that constantly reminding me it's available or something. I almost rear-ended that car, and it's because of that stupid-ass truck up there. Man, you just screwed the pooch, dude. Now I can't get around. What is it with these stupid truck drivers? I'd run the shoulder until I'm up to speed before doing stupid jank shit like that. Just sitting in the row. Then decide, well, I'm gonna pull out now. You're gonna have two tandem trucks in both lanes because we're about the same speed right now. Finally pulling ahead of them, but still stupid. Okay, I'm gonna get in the right lane shortly. Maybe wait until after this other truck. I'll get in there and let some cars get down. Problem is, once I get over, cars are going to pass, and then I won't be able to pass this stupid fool. I almost guarantee this guy will know what you need. Actually, we're going to cut back over because I have a feeling we're going to catch up to him quickly. Yeah, it's not like Colorado. It's not quite as crazy as Colorado. Should be. I thought I had the lights on, but apparently I only had my parking lights. I didn't have the right ones on. I gotta get fuel at some point, so I'll have to keep an eye on that. Hopefully there's something along the way that's on the interstate or highway. Miles to go. I think we might be able to get by, but I really don't want to be running there on fumes if I can help it. Get there, we'll see if there's a load that we can pick up and repeat the process. This load is supposed to net us 20K. So, we'll have to see. It really doesn't. 172 miles. Nice. It's unfortunate that the way the timing is, we're going to be doing mostly night driving now. But this is the way it is. So if I'm able, then we'll get a load when this is dropped off, and we'll have the guy rest up, and then it'll be daylight for the next run that we do. They got me going over to the right lane again. I bet you anything, it's a stupid exit. And I'll have to jump back over to the other lane again. Not always, but it seems like more often than not, that's the way it is. But who knows, we might have to exit anyway. This might be where we're supposed to go. I think it's telling us we gotta go in this lane again. Yep, and of course we're blocked by cars because we're in the wrong freaking lane. Gotta love it. The GPS people are morons in this game. Why would you send somebody into a lane that, if they get blocked by traffic, it's going to take them out of the most direct route? Well, jeez, I didn't even use my directional. At least I didn't hit that freaking pole again. Damn, that would suck. Now I gotta see if I'm in the exit. Where is this inspection station? Right here. Get out of the damn road, you stupid fool. Inbreed son of a bitch. There we go. Activated that retarder thing. I was stuck behind a retarder, a police officer there, just sitting there on the road. Alright, less than 200 to go, and I think we're going to deliver this son of a gun early, but we got to stop for fuel somewhere. Hopefully there's something on the interstate, or highway, wherever this, whatever they call this. We are, we call them interstates, but other places call them highways. they do have a gas station in there, but I don't know if I want to navigate the streets with these trailers. Don't think we'll run out of fuel, but you never know, it could happen. I like the fact that the speed is 80, and I'm, you know, got it pegged down, and I'm going 70, 75. And I don't feel the need to be too worried about, you know, my speed, whereas most of the time I'm constantly having to think about it. And of course, I still should think about it, but it's not bad. I'm feeling this truck up here is slow because people are going right around me. I think the next exit we'll have to stop and see if we can get fuel, because I am starting to get a little nervous. There's rest areas, unfortunately no fill-in stations. It's too bad they didn't have one in there, that'd be awesome. Wouldn't have them rest, but I'd have to get fuel for sure. I don't know, we might be able to have enough. I don't know, we'll see. Just enough to get it delivered, and then the rest we'll have to fill up before we go out again. But if I see one, I'll swing in and get it. Get filled up. Lane must be, we're going up a hill or something. Assuming, oh, it's a way station coming up, but we just the way station, so we should be able to bypass this one. God, it's hot in here. What the hell? Can't catch a break. No, I've got to pull in for the stupid way station. Thank you. get stuck behind the retard convo, because that's what it's going to be, because these guys are just going to crawl out to the interstate, and then they're going to sit there and just wait. That's 73 miles to go. I don't know. It's kind of tough. And if I go off the road and kind of look, I could run out, so. What I mean is off the interstate, go to town or whatever, and you run the risk of running out and you're putting yourself off course. And I could be just crawling into the dang place on fumes. I feel it would be stupid. Now if I see one on the interstate right here on the highway, I can just pull into and then pull back out. It'd be ideal. Come on, guys! God, that's so stupid. What an accident he could have created. Taking their chances today, the fuel level being like a thumbnail, practically, thick, on the visual meter over there, but we'll have to take our chances, because I don't know what else to do. I can't see, no kidding. Got one that I can see. I will jump right off the interstate and get it, but there's no point in me at 35 miles to go, and we're almost there, you know. I think we're off on this exit here. Because we're not in a hurry for the delivery at all. We have plenty of time. There's a fuel station right here, so we can make a right instead of the left, and we'll hit that place up. It's a red light. Not a red light, but a light situation. You asshole. Red light violation, $700. Are you kidding me? I stopped at that light. It's a right on red. I've never seen such retarded in all my life. I'm running out of fuel. I gotta get freaking gas, and you guys are giving me freaking red light tickets. Stupid. Thank you. this is a little crazy. I'm going over all kinds of crazy stuff. But we're going to detach the trucks. Or detach the trailer, all right? We're not detaching the truck. We kind of are, too, but... And then we're going to get filled up. There, we are now getting filled up. We're almost at the end of this load here, so there's no point in the... Managed to get fuel, so the stress level is definitely lower. So now it's just a matter of us getting on the road and making this delivery, which is just a stone throw away practically in this world. Had enough to get there, but who the hell wants to sit there and keep thinking about, you know, the red light on the thing is for gas or diesel is going off and it's going to alert you every 2 minutes. It's like, nah, I don't need that. There's a place to fill this up, to put diesel in this son of a bitch. I'm going to go there because there's no point trying to get the rest of this delivery finished on an empty fuel tank. Well, it's nice that I discovered a new viewpoint, but what good is that viewpoint when it's in the middle of the night? I'm going to have to do one of those where I can pull in and see what that's all about, because I've done a lot of episodes and I haven't done any of that stuff. I've just been about getting those loads done. I think that's a bobtailing type thing. When you're not pulling a load, you can just go in there and just check it out. Alright, this is the first delivery we've made to Twin Falls, so that's cool. Getting some of these places checked off the list. Not that there's any kind of list that we have, but... But it's good to take loads to places we haven't been. this load is supposed to be between 5 and 6:30, so we're going to be a couple hours early, which is nice. I'm guessing right on red does not apply for trucks, I'm going to assume. Probably because it's so long of a vehicle that, you know, by the time you pull out, there could be cars coming and you're in their way. So, yeah, it's probably, that's the reason I keep getting all these tickets on right on red, is you got a normal car or whatever, you can do it. Get this delivered, pick up another load perhaps. Well, obviously we're not going to deliver the load now, but we got to make that. We got to go kind of, not right, but sort of front the, yeah, that's weird. This is weird, like, weird intersection, actually. I'm not sure which light I'm supposed to pay attention to. I guess the one straight ahead. Because it doesn't matter, they're all active at the same time. Their speed, and I'm like, there's just a cop that just passed, so we're not doing that. Alright, so we go straight, and then there's another right after that. Keep saying how we're going to be early and all that. We are, but the way it's taken almost as long just to get there from the gas pumps, diesel pumps, that it is anywhere else because of all these traffic lights. Well, I ain't taking any chances. Could have made it, but it was still yellow, and who knows, it might have been red when we get through it or something and get a ticket. And I'm like, nope, I already lost $700 for that already, so. I think we're going to go overhead, deal with this one. I had a feeling that I had to take that kind of weird. Right in here, I believe. All right, we got that load delivered, so we're gonna skip it. That's where we'll leave it. That was a good episode. Made it to destination. We are all squared away. I think we'll leave it there, and then we will pick it up in the next one. If you enjoyed the content, please give it a big thumbs up. And also, if you would help out by subscribing, it would be greatly appreciated. We will see you in the next one.